And now I would like to talk to you about two types of boundaries, reactive boundaries and proactive boundaries. And reactive boundaries are our emotional reaction to the situation. When a child is screaming, crying, throwing food on the floor, throwing toys, a child is saying no. No, I don't want it. I will not do it. A child is protesting. And often a child does not tell us what he wants. He just saying no. And this is normal for a child up to 6-7 years old. This is how children learn how to protect their boundaries, how to protect their territory, their toys. And parents' reaction is extremely important during this period. Parents should teach a child that it's not okay to scream, it's not okay to throw food on the floor, it's not okay to break things, it's not okay to bite other people, or it's not okay to hit other people, but it's okay to say no. If you don't like something, you should say no, you should speak up. You should not hurt other people, you should not scream, but you should be able to speak up and talk about your feelings. And parents should teach actually the child how to speak up, how to find the solution in difficult situation, how to negotiate and how to find a compromise. But parents often miss this second part. They punish children for screaming, they punish children for being rude, they do not teach a child how to protect the boundaries, and the child is learning that I should not scream, I should not show my negative feelings, I just have to keep it to myself. And as a result, a child learns either a victim role or he becomes a selfish narcissist. And the person with the victim type of personality, it is a person who gets upset from small things, a person who creates a drama, a person who slams the doors, a person who manipulates, lies, cries, creates conflict, and always blames the other for his problems. And at the same time, this person suffers a lot. These people often come to therapists because they suffer. They feel that nobody appreciates them, nobody cares about them, nobody understands them. And often a person with a victim type of personality develops psychosomatic symptoms, high blood pressure, anxieties, constant stress. And living in constant stress and anxiety can bring us to bigger medical issues. The second type, if the parents did not teach a child how to behave, and they allow him to do whatever he wants to do, and then we might have, as a result, a narcissist person who behaves aggressively, often abusive, and this person can physically hurt others, or he can physically hurt animals, or he might use an abusive word, like psychological abuse. A narcissist manipulates. A narcissist does not respect the opinion of other people. He believes that he can violate laws, he can violate rules, he can be rude and aggressive. But if other people violate his boundaries, if other people break his rules, then he becomes cruel, cold, and violent. Reactive boundaries always based on emotions. When I scream, it means that I'm mad. If I feel ashamed, I can cry and manipulate and blame others. When people disagree with me, I have to prove that I'm right. They have to agree with me. And some narcissists can say that they regret about their reactions later. But if a person does not know how to manage his anger, if a person does not know how to respect other people, it does not mean that you should forgive him. It does not mean that you should ignore his rude behavior, even if he regrets about this later. You should not sacrifice yourself, your desires, your dreams just because another person does not know how to control his anger. So the second type of boundaries is proactive boundaries. And proactive boundaries are when a person chooses his reaction. Everybody has a choice, and often we forget about it. You should make your choice based on who you are. Who are you talking to? Is it a family member? Is it your boss? Is it your coworker, or is it your neighbor? You should make your choice based on the result that you want to achieve at the end. Do you want to keep your job, or do you want to keep your friendship? Do you want to keep your family relationship or not? And the second element that's very important that you should consider is it the first time when this person is rude to you, or he did it many times before? You always have a choice. In any situation with any person, you have a choice. And during the 8 weeks of healing the inner child of the online training, you will learn 4 ways to respond to rudeness and 5 ways to find a solution in any situation. And if you would like to learn more about this training, please click the link below this video, and you can go and see topics and like program for all 8 weeks of training. If you like this video so far, please click like. Please let me know in comments. Your comments is extremely important to me. Don't keep it to yourself. If you like this video, please share your thoughts, your ideas, and click like and subscribe. Okay, healthy boundaries. Anybody can learn how to create healthy boundaries, how to say no, and you can learn this too. The longer we use our old behavior patterns, the more we suffer. You can continue to live in resentment, you can continue to suppress your inner anger, you can continue to play a victim role, you can remain to be silent, you can swallow your pain and hope that one day it will be a miracle and you will be free. Or you can change your life and heal your inner child and heal your childhood trauma. And reactive boundaries also always lead to addictive relationship, to pain and to frustration. And I'm offering you to learn how to use proactive boundaries, how to heal your inner child, how to get your self-worthiness back, how to work on your pain and work on your self-esteem and self-confidence. And life moves forward. Even if you stay on the same level, life moves forward. And by staying on the same level, you're actually drawing deeper and deeper down. And one day it might be too late to create a successful career. It might be too late to have a baby. It might be too late to quit smoking because you already have cancer. So this is your choice. You can continue living in your current situation, or you can work on yourself and you can heal yourself. If you have dreams, your desires, if you don't know how to achieve them, then probably your inner child is afraid. And if you did not see my first webinar, it's absolutely free, about the inner child, who he is, how to notice your inner child. The link will be below this video. Click the link and learn about your inner child. So your inner boy or inner girl does not want you to speak up for yourself because he is afraid. And as a result, you cannot achieve your dreams, you cannot achieve your goals, you cannot have the life that you really, really want. You cannot create healthy boundaries, healthy relationship. And if your child is afraid, then your self-esteem is low and you cannot live the life that you deserve, the life that you really, really want. And today I would like to offer you a meditation. It's a guided meditation that is called My Inner House. And this meditation will help you to evaluate your boundaries and understand yourself better. It will also help you to see how do you present yourself in this world. And before we will do meditation, I would like to give you a short overview of the exercise so you will know what to expect. So at first I will ask you to relax and I will guide you through the relaxation process, and then I will ask you to imagine a house. And you can imagine any house, and we're not gonna go inside the house. In this meditation, we're gonna look outside. Anything that you see outside will be extremely important. And don't worry, if you see yourself inside the house, I will guide you and I will ask you to go outside. And then I will ask you several questions like, how big is the house? How tall is the house? What do you see around you? Do you see neighbors? Do you have a backyard? And all those questions. And then at the end of the meditation, we will discuss the symbols of this practice, and we're gonna decode the image that you've seen in this meditation. Okay, so find a comfortable position. Make sure that nobody is gonna disturb you for the next 5, 7, maybe 10 minutes. Turn off your phones. Make sure that nobody will call you, text you, and you're not gonna be distracted by any sound. Close your eyes. You can keep your eyes open. This is up to you. I recommend you to close your eyes, but if you want to keep them open, if you don't feel comfortable with closed eyes, you can do it with open eyes as well. Allow your body to relax. Take a deep breath in and out. And another deep breath in and out. And the third breath in and out. Allow your body to relax. And let your subconscious mind guide you. As you go deeper into the relaxation, any noise and sounds will only help you to connect with your inner world and imagine images. Allow your body to relax more and more, deeper and deeper. Relax your shoulders, your elbows, relax your wrists and every finger on your hands. At some point, allow your chest to relax. Your breathing might get in deeper and slower. Relax your abdominal muscles. Allow the wave of relaxation travel down to your belly. Relax your legs. Relax your knees, relax your ankles, relax your feet. At some point, start relaxing your back muscles, relax your lower back, your middle back, your upper back. Allow all the muscles along your spine to relax. Relax your neck, the back of your head, your temples. Relax your forehead, eyebrows, relax your cheeks, jaw, and relax your eyes. Staying with eyes closed, you can hear my voice and imagine images. And now imagine a house. It can be any house that you've seen in your real life, or some imaginary house. Anything that you see is good and important. Now, please notice how big is your house. How tall is your house? What material does it make of? Can you see the roof? What color is it? What shape is it? Flat, pointed, or any other shape? What is it made from? Does your house have windows or balconies? If yes, how many do you see? Do you see any blinds or curtains? What does the front door look like? Is it big? What color is it? Do you have a key from this house or not? What do you see around the house? Is there any fence? Does it have a big fence or small fence? Is it solid or transparent? Look carefully and try to notice all the details. Does your house have a gate or entrance? Now try to imagine that you are going around the house and try to inspect it from each side. Take your time and actually go around. You might notice that some sides of the house or some sides of the yard is closed. Just notice, what do you see? When you're walking around the house, try to notice where your house is located. Do you see any neighbors, any other houses around or not? What is your general impression of this house? Do you like it? Do you want to live in this house or not really? Look around. Try to remember all the details. And find a comfortable place where you can complete this guided meditation and return to your room. Open your eyes. Look around. Name three objects that you see. You can stretch. You can touch your body, your arms, your legs. Make sure that you get back. And please write in chat or write in comments below the video, what did you see? And how do you feel right now? This is very important. give me some feedback and I can give you my feedback on your feedback. I highly recommend to take color pencils, marker, crayons, any coloring tools and draw the house that you saw during the meditation, so you can connect one more time to this picture. And people who have already signed up for the premium and VIP package of the upcoming training, you can email me your pictures and we will discuss it later in details. And if you're gonna watch this video later, not during live broadcast, you can click pause right now, stop the video, take pencils, markers, crayons, draw the house, and then continue watching this video, because right now I will give you some information about the symbols of this meditation. Okay, so the decoding of the meditation, the fence. The fence is the symbol of your personal boundaries. Today we were talking a lot about boundaries. And the fence is the symbol of your boundaries. How tall are they? How thick are they? How transparent are they? How your boundaries look like? When you were next to your house and you were looking to the outside through the fence, were you able to see the outside world or not? Maybe fence was blocking your view. So the fence is the symbol of the boundaries that you have in your life right now. If you did not have a fence, it means that you are not protecting your interests, your boundaries at all. It means that you allow other people to use you. It means that you cannot say no, and you don't know how to say no at all. So if you don't have fence, it means that your boundaries are absent. You don't have any boundaries. The front yard. The front yard is the symbol of how you present yourself in this world. For example, people who have a perfect front yard in the meditation, they have a perfect Facebook page, they have a perfect Instagram page. They have amazing pictures, and when you look at their Instagram page, it's like, wow, this person is living magical life. But the front yard is only the presentation of the house. So your account on social media is the presentation of your life, and your front yard in this meditation is the presentation of you in this world. How do you present yourself in this world? The house itself, the shape, the color, and the roof. All those elements represent you, your mental health, your anxiety level, and basically this is how you see yourself in the world. If you had the key to the house, it means that you know how to connect to yourself. You know how to connect to your inner desires, and you know how to connect to your true feelings. Windows and balconies. Windows and balconies represent how do you communicate with the outside world, and are mostly with the people who are close to you. So fence is mostly with the people in general, with other people in your life. But windows and balconies is your family members, your husband, wife, boyfriend, your kids. And if you allow them to be part of your life, then you probably have windows, and windows are not closed, are not locked, like you can see something through them, you can see a little bit of the house inside. So you allow your close family members to be close and to be in close, deep connections with you. The area behind the house, the hidden territory, represents your secrets, your fears, and your inner conflict, and any psychological traumas that you might have. Something that you are hiding from other people, and if you were not able to walk around the house, then it means that there is something that you are ignoring. You're trying to hide it from yourself. You're running away from your own fears. You don't want to face them. You're running away from some pain, or maybe something in your past experience, probably in your childhood. If you saw a huge castle, big houses, all those big houses, castles, pointed roof, are symbols of magical thinking, psychological immaturity. You might be in your 40s, 50s, but on a psychological level, you are still a child. And people who are stuck in this psychological childhood, of course, they cannot protect their boundaries. Of course, for them, it's extremely hard to say no. Of course, they don't want to hurt other people. So, if you saw huge house, a castle, a Disney dream palace, right? Then you have to work on your inner child. You have to work on your self-worth and your self-confidence and self-acceptance. Neighbors. Neighbors are a symbol of your perception of other people. Did you see any fence or sidewalk between you and the other house? How far did you see your neighbors? How close they were to your house? Did you like how the distance, or it was too far or too close? Please write in comments below the video what did you see, and after the webinar I will read your comments and I will help you to decode it. So if you would like to get my feedback, just below the video write in comments what you saw and your question. Like, for example, I saw a cat next to my house. What it can what it represents. Or for example, you can say, my house did not have a roof, or my house was standing next to the river. What does it mean? Please write your comments below this video, and I will reply to you and help you to decode this image. And again, people who have already signed up for the premium and VIP package for the upcoming training, 8 weeks of healing their inner child, you can just email me your pictures and we will discuss it later in details. And before we're gonna end this webinar, if you like this video, please click like, let me know in comments. This is extremely important to me. And when I see your like, it motivates me and I want to create more and more videos. Share this video on your social media networks, on your Facebook, on your Twitter, on your Instagram. Please help me to spread out the word about psychology of happiness, about my business, because my mission is to create more free webinars and affordable trainings that will help people to overcome their fears and create the life that they really, really want. Below this video, you can find the links, you can go through the program, you can see all the topic, and please join me on Facebook and on Instagram. This is all the information that I prepared for you today, and I hope that you enjoy this video. And if you find it helpful, please click like, subscribe, and share. And again, my name is Elena Semenek, and this is Psychology of Happiness, where happiness is the purpose of life. See you next time. Bye-bye.